Time to play some more like Crusader. In the last episode, we found the tap handle, which allows us to fill certain rooms with water and explore further into the dungeon. This puzzle is a little counterintuitive. That barrel down there isn't for blowing up. All you do with it is place it under that platform, so so you can push this barrel. That's odd. Why isn't it letting me push it? How very strange. Okay. Well, color me confused. I thought that was all there was to this puzzle. Apparently I was mistaken. Let's try it again. Okay, I know for a fact that you can't push this barrel onto this platform by itself, because that blue platform will sink, and you won't be able to do anything with that. I thought for sure all you had to do was put that other barrel under the platform. Okay, it's holding that up. Oh, by the way, there's some sort of an invisible wall here, which is why we can't just push the barrel this way. I forgot that wasn't really that obvious. Okay, I guess that must have just been a fluke the first time. And more worms. Doing a pretty good amount of damage to these guys now. Hey, a steak. Steaks are good. Ow! Fire! Fire! Hey, another steak. It's our lucky day. I wonder if these guys always give you steak. So, that would make this a very useful room. See, fire. We got a fire thing last time. Okay, so it doesn't always give you steak. Oh well. There are certain enemies in this game that are more likely than others to give you certain things. Okay, probably the reason he gave us fire is because magic is required for this puzzle. Okay, well, maybe it's not required, since it gives you a little bit of a starting... A little bit of time to get back to the platform. Oh, crap. There we go. Key 3. Key 3PO. Let's see, just for demonstration. Yep, can't push it this way. Why? I'd have to go out on a limb and say that a wizard did it. Okay, I guess we have to go back to where the other tap was, now that we have the handle. I'm going ahead and drain that room. Yeah. Hey, buddy. And we'll probably put on a costume again in a little bit when we run into more aggressive goblins. Oh, Simon, how I hate you and your memory testing ways. Can we go through this door now? I think so. Now that we have key 3. Hey, who are you? Well, well, my friend. I was looking for something to eat, but there was only an old stone tablet. The ancient manuscript Roke was looking for. The princess in the castle may be able to read it. She's studying ancient script. Oh, that's convenient. Let's see what that tablet looks like. Dot, dot, dot. They didn't even invent a fake language for it. There's that door that we need to swim to. Oh boy, red slimes. My most hated of all slimes. This part involves cutting these pendulums so they don't push the barrel onto the spikes. It's Simon, take 2. I like repetition. Repetition makes it a lot easier. Concentrating. Please be all. Please be all. Yes! Thank you! And we got the chainmail. Which is worse than what we already had. For the love of God! Oh, I just did that for no reason. I thought that was going to be something important. Is that really all that's up there? Oh. Okay. Well. Let's drain the quarry. And now we have to take the stone tablet back to the princess for whatever reason so she can decipher the text and let us know what it says. We've almost completely finished this map, so let's see if I can get those last couple of rooms before we're done. The teleporter's gotta be around here somewhere. Okay, we're getting closer to that room with the goblins that we need the costume to get past. I think we should be able to get there in the next minute or so. Gobble gobble, gobble gobble. We accept you. This room's full of good stuff. Tomato, tomato, tomato. And a barrel there for some reason. One of us. Gobble gobble. Lord Bloodrook is looking for a very old stone tablet. Uh-oh, he's talking of swapping it for this room full of food. Okay, I don't know where the teleporter for this part is, so I guess we'll go back there manually. See you next time.